Well, hello and welcome to the Easy Shop. I'm Marco and today I have a new project. It will be to create some cooling fins for a set of three diodes that I will be using as a part of the electrical system for a cooling fan that will be positioned on top of the oil cooler on the airplane that is already flying. All of this is experimental. We're at a pretty good stage with that project. It's all working just fine right now, but the diodes are getting a little warm, so we're going to be working on a little set of coolers for it. So let me just show you what we're trying to make. So part of the problem is that I need diodes that can put up with about 10 to 15 amps running that fan. I tried this kind, that's not big enough. I tried this other kind, they're a little bit better, but they get very hot. So I decided to use even bigger diodes, and these ones, each of them is good enough to do the job, but they also get a little bit warm. And so I'm trying to run three of them in parallel, and when I do that, the temperature decreases on all of them. And these little carriers that you see is a 3D printed version of what I will be trying to machine. So this will be made completely out of aluminum. Now, it's pretty important that there's no connection between the little legs here and the aluminum cooler. Otherwise we short the diodes and all kinds of crazy things could happen. Why am I going through all this trouble? Well, I already bought these diodes and I'm not gonna throw them away. And so right now the fan is running just fine with two diodes in parallel and no cooling whatsoever. However, I measured them and the hottest they get to about 165 degrees Fahrenheit, which is not really that hot. But because this is going to be sitting on the airplane, I mean inside the airplane, and it's probably going to be attached to the sidewall of the airplane, I don't really want that kind of temperature in contact with the fiberglass. So I figure if I, instead of two, I run three of them, the temperature would be even lower, and if I use a set of fins like this, that should help to dissipate the heat and to the point that shouldn't be any problem. So. There's a few more parts to this. Let me get back in focus. So to make sure that the diodes do not slide out, there will be a little cover like so, and this should completely hold the diodes in the fins, within the fins. And there will be two screws right there that I'm not going to bother putting on right now. The other thing that I would like to show you though, just to make sure that none of these legs ever get in contact with any other metal items accidentally in the airplane, there will be a 3D printed part, and this is the one, and the only function this part has is to actually cover the little bare legs of the diodes. If I can get them slide in like this, there we go, and so that there's no way that these little legs are gonna be able to touch anything else. Now on the bottom here you see a couple of channels, and what I will do, the wires will come in from one side or the other, I haven't decided yet, but it'll be a 14 gauge wire and it will be soldered to all of the little legs, then will be cut flush. So this will be ready for mounting on the sidewall. And just to give you an idea how the mounting is gonna happen, let me use a different 3D printed part. So this is an earlier version. There will be this type of device attached to the sidewall. This is called click bonds with some fiberglass over the top. And it's a little tight here, but the fins will be mounted on it. It'll be a washer and then a little tiny nut, and this will be attached permanently to the sidewalls of the airplane. And so that is the project. When it's finished, it will look again kind of like this. But what do you say we get on with it? So I found a piece of scrap aluminum that looks like it's gonna fit just fine. And let's go take it to the bandsaw, cut it up, and then we'll start machining it. Very well, we're at the mill now, and we're getting ready to machine the piece of aluminum that we cut earlier. You can see it's sitting on another aluminum piece, and it's glued to the bottom piece using this super glue and activator. I'll leave the description for it in the link below where you can get it. This is a method that was shown by John Saunders of NYC CNC. It's my first time trying it. The nice thing about it is that it should allow us to machine all the way around the part itself very easily without running into anything. So we'll give it a shot. Hopefully that works. If it doesn't, we'll have to do it again. But again, these are the activator and the super glue that I got from Amazon. We'll be right back.
Well, we're done with the machining and we came up with the metal version of those cooling fins I showed you a little bit earlier. We had a few little problems, nothing major, some imperfections that weren't worth stopping to fix in the code. So, I mean, they're just cooling fins. So I'll tighten up the shot here and show you a little bit what I'm talking about. But other than that, it works pretty good. I've had to improvise a couple of in a couple of places. So the dimensions are not exactly the way they were before, but everything fits, so it should be good to go. I'm gonna zoom in now and show you what it looks like. All right, so this is one, the 3D printed version. This is the one that we just machined. So they look pretty similar. As you can see, I decided to counterbore the holes here a little bit because those click bonds are a little on the short side. Let me get it back in the frame and see what else. Yeah, some of the corners here I decided to go a little bit with a wider diameter chamfer in all these places, just because my smaller end mill was a little too short this way and it wasn't gonna reach to the bottom there. So other than that, there's a couple blemishes you might be able to see right here and right here. That's what I was talking about earlier. Those are issues with the lead in and lead out for cutting these slots. Again, not a big deal. I mean, I could care less. This, nobody's ever gonna see this again, at least in real life. And so it wasn't worth stopping everything and reprogramming it. And also, this was the last things I did in the machining, so I wasn't gonna start a new one of these just for this little blemish. So let's see, let me grab diode. Here's one of the big diodes that's supposed to fit in there, and as you can see, it fits pretty good in there. I hope it's in focus. Let me try it again. Fits pretty good. Nothing touches on this side, so that's exactly what we were looking for. Of course, this leg is going to be bent down a little bit. And I'll put some thermal paste on the inside so that the heat can transfer a little more efficiently. And as far as the cover for this, I was originally going to machine one of these in aluminum, but it's a bit of a pain. It's such a small piece. And I figure with three of these, the temperature's got to be around 104 degrees Fahrenheit or so. So I think I'd just rather keep this ABS part. I mean, the ABS melts over 200 degrees and this is not gonna go anywhere near that. So let me put it all together and take another quick shot to show you the final version of it. So here it is, all put together. You can see I only have one click bond installed. The rest of them are at the hanger, and so you're just gonna have to imagine what it looked like with the two click bonds. Again, the click bonds is the part that attaches directly to the airplane, and then the rest will attach to the click bonds with the two bolts, one here and one here. But I say this worked out better than I expected. The part is very secure down here. Remember, is where the thick wires are gonna come in, connect to all of these terminals. Are going to be soldered to all these terminals, then they will be clipped flush and this will be ready to be attached to the sidewall of the airplane. And once in use, the diodes are going to heat up a little bit, but this will go a long way toward keeping things cool and in check. So I think we've taken all reasonable precautions to make sure that nothing shorts these little leads. So I'm pretty happy. And if you want to see the installation, it's gonna come up here in a few weeks probably. I will install it in the airplane and I will probably write another blog post on longeasyproject.blogspot.com, and the link will be below in the description for this video as well as at the end of the trailer. All right, I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time. Ciao.